all of us, you know. And there are too many people, as we know, who have fell foul of, you know, propaganda and are busily engaged in hating their neighbour. They wouldn't see it as that, of course. But when Jesus said, you know, love your neighbour as yourself, he did not say and hate a few of them or hate that person down the road, you know. So really, we really have to practice that love that we say. You know, we declare ourselves to be Christians, and I'm going to be giving a teaching session on the Nexus Learning Centre on Saturday the 17th. I'll put some little details about it up, because apparently I can invite a few friends. They do it on a Zoom meeting. And those of us who know these various centres, spiritually centres in Great Britain, know about Hafani Coed, and they have talked there, and they've actually done me the honour of asking me if I would come on and talk about my Christian spiritualism, and for an hour. I don't know how I'll be able to manage that. And then I'm allowed to get 10 minutes break, and then I can have another hour answering people's questions. So that should be very interesting. But the fact is this, that yes, we are Christian, and if people ask us why we're Christian and spiritualists, we can tell them because we do our best to follow the teachings and example of Jesus. You know, it's wonderful words. And, you know, the two commandments that he told us that were his own commandments too, because the Jews also follow those two commandments, to love the Lord thy God with all thy soul, with all thy heart, and with all thy might and mind, and to love thy neighbour as thyself. Both of those commandments are in the Old Testament, and Jesus, as you know, was a Jew, although somebody said to me once, he couldn't have been a Jew because he wasn't rich. No, that was what was said to me. Or, you know, never mind. So the thing is this, that, you know, they are very good tenets to hold on to, and Jesus said they are the greatest of the two commandments. So I think, really, I would ask everybody, you know, to follow that themselves. Whether or not they say they're Christian, it doesn't matter, because in any case, it came from the Jewish Bible in the first place. So that's okay. And of course, Islam also reveres Jesus as a prophet and would agree with me on that and would agree with us on that. So, you know, although there are all these different spiritual pathways in the world, as long as you love your neighbour as yourself, and as long as you love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and might and mind and your intellect, you can't go far wrong. And I think that people who spew their malice, you know, out there, we need to block them by education of the population and tell them that's not the way. Don't worry about that. There's no big monsters going to come and walk through. Can you imagine? Come and walk through the doors of the Vatican any day soon or anywhere else come to that. Do you think that's why the cathedral doors are always so large? Perhaps that's a conspiracy to allow these, you know, these wicked giants to walk through them when they come and take over the world. Or, So I'll leave you with those happy thoughts. And what I said to Kathy before I came on this, you know, here this evening, what we did, we've adopted a little gnome that is sitting on a toilet or a carsy, if you're a bit rough like what I is, reading a newspaper with a little toilet roll. So he's a posh gnome. Because when my dad used to go and sit in the outdoor toilet reading the newspaper, because I knew that, because I had to go and tell him that it was time for dinner or something, because he used to creep out there on a Sunday morning and stay there with his paper. We never had toilet roll. We had newspaper that was cut into four and put on a piece of string, but we didn't actually cut it. Now, Kathy is coming in with what I told her we should not show anybody.
Hang on, bear with.
Can Can you see our home?
Hang on. There you go.
Now, she wanted to show that, and I said, no, we can't do that, dear, because what we have to remember at any spiritualist service, is that there may be somebody distraught in the congregation, and we're expected to uplift them. So, anyway, she's got her own way. I was prompted by spirit to mention that. So, you know, like every good medium, I blame my guides. And I hope that everybody found that amusing and not too awful. And that if you were feeling distraught, distressed, and otherwise miserable before you came on to this service this evening, that you feel a little bit more cheered up. So with those words, I'll say God bless you, God bless everybody, and don't forget, keep the faith. And whatever your faith is, keep it. And don't let people assail it with their nasty stories and rumours. You know, you stay doing what you're doing. It'll be fine. And you will be fine.
Yeah. Thank you, Lyn. I have to say that everyone is loving your, dare I say it, effing address tonight.
I always say flaming Ada.
Yes. Oh, be careful mentioning anything to do with Ada and the songs they sing. You know, some people ask me, you know, what's it like sitting in circle with Reverend Lyn Gibb-de? That is exactly what it's like. You have seen the opening of a circle tonight, and it really, really does give you a proper human perspective. And I know there's laughter and there's jokes and there's upliftment, which is absolutely brilliant right from the beginning. Gordon prompted me to say it, and we got it, definitely. But the point is, there's always a really important message there, and you know, everyone has been uplifted. Everyone has had a laugh, but they've also taken note. Because if you're saying that, no one's going to listen. But when you actually grab people by the skin of the teeth, the scruff of the neck, or the roll that they roll with, or newspaper that they roll with, then you've got it. I mean, I saw about a year ago, somebody sent me a link to a minister in the Church of England who does stand-up comedy as part of his congregational addresses. And I'm thinking, we've been doing that years, you know. And as the old saying goes, from absolutely fabulous, it ain't all bad, so lighten up. We're still here, that's what matters. We're still here to fight another day, live another day, even if we do feel like what Lyn said. So Lyn, as ever, really, thank you so much for your wise words and your upliftment too.
Thank you,
it's also nice not to have an echo as well. Well done.
Well, it's just on my little phone, you see, so I can't actually see any words, put it that way, so I can see no comments whatsoever. It's just a white line to me. Cause it's only a little digi phone, but I just got so fed up trying to work out how not to have an echo. I tried the earphone thing, but of course my ears are so bad, my head's bad, so I couldn't wear them. And I thought, no, that's it. It will be the phone. And I'm sure people will forgive me for that.
Brilliant. No, absolutely, absolutely. And I've got a few more ideas to work on as well, but once the next few weeks are up and we're allowed to start interacting, I can come round and have a bit of a tweak with your equipment.
Yeah, thank you so much, as the actress said to the bishop.
Quite literally. No, it's the bishop that said that, the archbishop said to the bishop in this case, isn't it?
Well, yes, dear.
And on that note, my love, I'll say God bless and see you later. Well, Tony, my friend, it has been an uplifting start to a Thursday night.
How do we follow that?
No, this is it. Usually on a Tuesday night it was, we would follow up with a meditation and then some tea and biscuits after. But look, the one thing that I always said about ministry is that I'm not going to change. Just because I've been ordained, I'm not suddenly going to become holier than now. I got to where I am because of who I am, so why would I then change it? Lyn is the epitome of that. And that's where I learned that lesson, friends. So wonderful, my friends. Now, let's see if Spirit can tie in with a reading with that one. Knowing who picks the readings, it's always quite likely. Alan, are you there, Reverend Alan?
I certainly am, Robin, and how do you follow that? Well, I did pick tonight's reading. It came to me quite quickly, actually, within a few minutes. And it's called Life is a Journey, and it's by my good old friend, Anonymous. Life is but a stopping place, a pause in what's to be, a resting place along the road to sweet eternity. We all have different journeys, different paths along the way. We all were meant to learn some things, but never meant to stay. Our destination is a place far greater than we know. For some the journey's quicker, and for some the journey's slow. And when the journey finally ends, we'll claim a great reward and find an everlasting peace together with the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow.
And you know what? It really, really does. It really, really does tie in. And I love the way Spirit do that. And you know, especially Lyn was also talking about with Jesus saying, which are the most important commandments? You've just described it really, really. So absolutely, thank you. And a perfect choice and beautiful read. Beautiful, beautiful, lovely words, Alan. Beautiful. And a certain gentleman with a familiar surname also made the comment that Mr. and Mrs. Moose write some great stuff.
Yes, they do.
They really, really do.
All beautiful, lovely words. So, Alan. Alan, as always, the provider of such wonderful words, found, borrowed and acquired, not stolen, from the wonderful earthly Akashic records, that is the internet.
I actually do get permission from up above to steal these.
Exactly, exactly.
And it's fine as long as you recognise the author.
Absolutely. In actual fact, that's exactly what the copyright laws say. For educational purposes, you are allowed to steal it.
Yes.
Alan, as ever, thank you so, so much. And do stick around for later on, dear.
I will do. Thank you.
Well, now is the time when we come to some healing. Now, the question I would ask you regarding healing... We can all hear that you're a couple of octaves lower than normal, and slightly, slightly husky. So we know you need some healing, but have you recovered from our address enough to not need healing for that?
Yes, I think so.
that was healing in itself, mate. I tell you. Yeah. Well, friends, now is the time when we do send out our healing thoughts to all those who are sick and suffering, in need of comfort. And what Lyn said. And as always, we send out our thoughts to everyone.